Hey, good morning. Happy Monday. This is our lesson for April 27th. We are in, I can't believe this, lesson 17, which is almost the last lesson of Unit 7, which is crazy. We are really close to being finished with an entire lesson. I'm sorry, an entire unit, and that's really exciting. Congratulations, those of you guys who have come so far and done so much learning. Remember back when we had in-person school, you really didn't have a lot of information about what a negative number was, and now you have so much. So I'm just really proud of you and excited to dive into today's lesson. Go ahead and set up your notes, please. This is Unit 7, Lesson 17, Common Multiples. This lesson's structure is a lot like last week's lesson on Thursday, lesson 16. Remember on Friday you took your quiz, but on Thursday we talked about common factors. Common? Yeah. So we're still talking about aspects of numbers that are in common or that are shared, but now we're talking about multiples. You learned about multiples way back when you were doing repeated addition. Repeated addition, remember, is like multiplication. And a lot of you are really, really good at something called skip counting. Something called? Yes. So a multiple of a number is basically if I skip counted by that number, all of those. So they're numbers that have the original number as a factor. So instead of on Thursdays, we talk about factors, we talk about breaking numbers apart into how to multiply to get them. When we talk about multiples, we're talking about skip counting out and seeing all the numbers that have our original number as a factor. Okay, that's what we're working on today. Let's get started. I want you to take a look at these two questions. Okay, we're talking about a florist today. Do you know what a florist does? Yeah, florist is a job. A florist works with flowers, makes flower arrangements and cares for flowers, all of that kind of thing. Let's read. A florist can order roses in bunches of 12. Roses seems important because I see lilies are coming up here too. And the lily is a different kind of flower in bunches of 8. Okay, so I'm already picturing a dozen roses, 12 roses, and I'm picturing 8 lilies, and those are like what the bouquet or the bunch is. Last month, she ordered the same number of roses and lilies. Okay, so she didn't order 12 roses and 8 lilies. She ordered the same number of each, but they come in these sets of 12 and 8. Does that make sense? Go ahead and read and answer question 1 and 2. I'm going to give you a 3-minute timer. And as always, if you need more time, you can take it once this timer goes off. On your mark. Get that go.
90% connected to Galaxy S10. Should I go? If you say that you are mine, I'll be here till the end of time. So you've got to let me know. Should I stay or should I go? It's always tease, tease, tease. Darling, you got to let me know. Should I stay or should I go? If you say that you are mine.
If you haven't done this already, go ahead and determine a way to organize your work so that you can figure out how many roses she could possibly order. Remember, they come in bunches of 12. So she could order 12 roses or 24 roses or 36 roses.
day is fine and this is black. So if you want me off your back, well, come on and let me know. Should I stay or should I go? Should I stay or should I go now? Should I stay or should I go now? If I go, there will be trouble. And if I stay, it will be double. So come on and let me know. You don't want me, said you. Exactly who I'm supposed to be. Don't you know which clothes even fit me? Come on and let me know.
All right, so there's our time. I didn't quite get done, but that's okay. We'll finish up together. I did think at first, I just want to know how many bunches or how many flowers she could order of each type. So I made a list that included skip counting. So I know she orders roses in bunches of 12. So she could order 12, 24, 36, 48, 60, 72, 84, 96. Notice that these are the multiples of 12. I also know that she could order lilies in bunches of 8. So she could order, I'm going to skip count by 8. She could order 8 lilies. That's one bunch. 2 bunches is 16 lilies, 24, 32, 40, 48, 56, 64, 72, 80, 88, and 96. You'll notice these are the multiples of 8. Okay, so then it says how many flowers of each could she order. We know she has to order the same amount. So I'm looking at these lists and I'm noticing that 24 is in both lists. So this tells me she could have ordered 24 lilies and 24 roses. She could not have ordered 16 lilies and 16 roses. Why not? A possible number of lilies because 16 is a multiple of 8. 16 is not a possible number of roses because it's not a multiple of 12. I can't get 12 roses and then I can't buy just only 4 more to get 16. Okay, so go ahead and find the rest of the multiples that are common, that are in both lists, okay? Let's see. Awesome. And you'll notice I stopped both lists. It said she ordered under 100. So I stopped my list when I got to close to 100. I couldn't do any more after that. So I found there are common multiples of 24, 48, 72, and 96. So I'm going to go ahead and figure out how many bunches of each flower that is so I can write my answer for number one. So I'm just going to write how many bunches each is. So 12 is one bunch, 24 is two. You can also use multiplication facts to figure this out. A really great way to organize this might be in a table. I might try that next time. You know, a table that had like how many bunches and then how many flowers. All right. So when I write my answer, I know that she ordered the same amount of each, so she could order. And I'm just going to do some bullet points here. Can you make your paper look like mine? She could order 24 of each, which is 2 bunches of roses and 3 bunches of lilies. Okay. 24 of each. And I'm just going to put in parentheses, that's 2 bunches roses and 3 bunches lilies. Awesome. Go ahead and do that for the other 3 common multiples. So 48, which was 4 bunches of roses. And 6 bunches of lilies. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and finish up on my paper quietly, and you finish up on your paper. Awesome. Go ahead and make sure your paper looks like mine. This is a great real world example of how we use this concept, which we'll talk about today, about common multiples, how we use it in real life. The florist might fill an order maybe for like a wedding, and the couple, the customer says, I want the same amount of lilies and roses because those are my 2 favorite flowers. Right. But the florist knows that she can only get them in these special bunches. So 12 roses and 8 lilies. She knows then that she could ask her customer, okay, are you interested in paying for 24 of each flower, 48, 72, or 96? Those are the only quantities that I can get for you. Which one sounds good? Right. Then she knows how much to order. Next, we're going to look at an example. We're going to do some defining of this new term, common multiple, and another one that I'll tell you about in just a second. But make sure your paper looks like this. This next example does not have context. It's not a word problem. So we're going to get some good practice with just finding these values of 2 numbers. Okay, but a lot of the work that we've done here will really help you. All right, we are going to move on. Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot. I think we had another question, didn't we? Maybe we're not going to move on yet. Let me look back at my classwork. Oh, yes. Number 2 is an important question. So I'm really glad I didn't forget about that one. Let's answer question 2. It says, what is the smallest number of bunches of roses that she could have ordered? And what about the smallest number of bunches of lilies? Explain. Okay, well, we've already got all of the work that will help us with that, right? So let's go ahead and answer question 2 together. My smallest amount is up here. I'm going to put a star by it. Can you do that on your paper? That's going to be your answer for question 2. The smallest amount of roses is, I'm just looking back there, 2 bunches. The smallest amount of lilies is 3 bunches. I'm just going to add in that that's 24 of each type of flower. That is 24 of each flower. That is 24 of each flower. So the least amount that the customer could get if the customer wanted equal amounts of flowers is they'd have to get 24 of each flower. Sometimes that's really helpful information when we use this kind of comparison. I could keep counting past 100 and go on with multiples forever, but often we're just wondering what are the common multiples. Sometimes we're wondering what is the least common multiple. Maybe you've heard that term before. Okay, so now here we are. We're going to look at question 3. All right, we are doing in the next few minutes question 3 through 5. So take a look. The least common multiple of 6 and 8 is 24. What do you think the term least common multiple means? Yeah. The least common multiple is a term that maybe you've heard before and maybe you haven't heard before. The least common multiple is the smallest, is that? The smallest multiple that two numbers share. So between 6 and 8, their multiples, well, the multiples of 6 are 6, 12, 18, 24, 30, 36, right? I'm just counting by sixes. If I count by eights, I'm wondering what's the smallest multiple that it shares with 6, right? So 8, 16, 24. Ooh, I said 24 in both lists, and it's the smallest, right? They would also cross paths at 48 and some others, right? Let's go ahead and jot down. You're going to need this for your Google form, so make sure you're writing with me. Here's question 3. Least common multiple. Oh, I'm sorry, you can't see my paper. Least common multiple. This is sometimes called LCM. Is the smallest multiple that two numbers share. Least common multiple is the smallest multiple that two numbers share. Awesome. In your Google form for today, it says, please answer question 3 from the video. This is question 3. So go ahead and type in with me. I'm not going to type the whole sentence and you don't have to either, but I am going to type in the smallest multiple that two numbers share. The smallest multiple that two numbers share. Awesome. Pause the video if you need some more time to answer that question in your Google form. We're going to do some practice finding the least common multiple. Here we go. Go ahead and set up on your paper space for number 4. Number 4, find all the multiples of 10 and 8 that are less than 100. Find the least common multiple of 10 and 8. So just like we did with that flower question where we listed out, we skip counted, I want you to do that with 10 and with 8 until you get to 100, okay? I'm going to go ahead and set a 1 minute timer to do that. Yep. All right, you have 20 seconds left. Again, you're just making a list of multiples of 10 and making a list of multiples of 8. And then you're going to find the least common multiple. Awesome. If you need more time, go ahead and pause here. Here are my lists of multiples of 10 and multiples of 8, okay? I'm just skip counting by 10s. I stopped at 100 because that's what the problem said to do. Skip count by 8s, I stopped by just shy of 100 because if I go one more, I'm over 100. So I don't need to go any farther than 96. The ones that are in both lists are called common multiples. They're called? Yes, so if I asked you on your quiz or your test, what are the common multiples of 10 and 8 that are under 100? You would say 40 and 80. But if I said, what is the least common multiple? You would just pick the smallest one. The least common multiple is 40. The least common multiple is 40. Make sure your paper looks like mine. Then pause the video and go enter your answer in the Google form for question 4. Awesome. Let's keep going. Last one, I want you to find all the multiples of 7 and 9 that are less than 100, and then I want you to find the least common multiple of 7 and 9, okay? I'm going to give you a minute to do that. Time starts now. I'm going to give you just a few more seconds, especially if your multiplication facts with sevens or with nines are a little bit slow or a little bit rusty. I just want to give you a little bit of extra time. All right, if you need more time, please pause the video. Here's my work for question 5. Here are the multiples of 7 up to 100. Here are the multiples of 9 up to 100. The only common multiple between 7 and 9 that is under 100 is 63. Therefore, the only common multiple under 100 of 7 and 9 is also the least common multiple. So the least common multiple is 63. Put a nice big star on that question if you got it right. Way to go. Let's review our lesson summary. This is a really great place to read with me and jot down some notes of some things that you want to remember or think that are really important. And I'll help you by highlighting that too, okay? But you have notes, not this paper. So make sure you're jotting down those important key parts. A multiple of a whole number is a product of that number with another whole number. For example, 20 is a multiple of 4 because 20 equals 5 times 4. I haven't demonstrated a lot of multiplying, right? But when we were counting bunches of roses, for example, 12 times 1 bunch, 12 times 2 bunches is 24, 12 times 3 bunches is 36, 12 times 4 bunches is 48 roses, right? So repeated addition is the same as multiplication. A common multiple for two whole numbers is a number that is a multiple of both numbers. For example, 20 is a multiple of 2. Do you agree with that? Yeah, if I skip count by twos, I'll land on 20 eventually. And a multiple of 5. If you find the multiples of 5, do you land on 20? Yes, that's a common multiple. So 20 is a common multiple of 2 and 5. The least common multiple, sometimes written as LCM, of two whole numbers is the smallest multiple they have in common. For example, 30 is the least common multiple of 6 and 10. One way to find the least common multiple of two numbers is to list multiples of each in order until we find the smallest multiple they have in common. Okay, here's an example. I'm not going to review it more because we've done already two examples in this video, but multiples of 4, multiples of 10, you can see I bolded the common multiples. 20 and 40 are both common multiples. They're both, yes, but 20 is the smallest number, so 20 is the least common multiple. Okay, your question of the day is how do you find the least common multiple? And I want to do it with you. It's really important that you get these two things on your notes, these two pieces that I highlighted. This is how you find it. List multiples of each in order and then find the smallest multiple they have in common, okay? Pause the video here if you need more time for your notes. Let me show you what I'm looking for in your Google form today. The question of the day is how to find the least common multiple. Should we list out the factors of each number? No, that's for greatest common factor, GCF. Should we list out the multiples of each number? Yes, you got it. Absolutely, we're going to list out the multiples of each number. Should we find the greatest multiple the numbers have in common? No, we don't want the greatest. In this case, with the least common multiple, we want to find the smallest multiple the numbers have in common. Okay. Make sure you answer that video question. I will see you back here tomorrow. Have an awesome day. Clear at 10 p.m. and go see Mr. Zamora at office hours. Bye.